right, real quick here. We are at a residence for some woodchucks. They've got them burrowing underneath the back of the barn here. They've kind of dug their hole right there where you see the trap. I kind of set the trap right in the runway, kind of buried it back in. That way, when the woodchuck comes out of the hole, the only thing he sees is light, and he goes right through the trap and hits my wires there, and we'll catch him there. That shouldn't take long, and we should have some fast results here. But they've been dealing with it for a while, and they finally gave me a call, and we got them set up here. So we'll keep an eye on this spot here, and show you guys what a trapped woodchuck looks like here, hopefully in the next day or two. I'm going to take you around to the other side, where they've also got a hole in the garden, and I'll show you what we got going on there. All right, we're inside the garden, or the soon-to-be garden. Got some raspberries in the corner, and the woodchucks have a hole going right down inside those raspberries. But again, kind of set up the same way with the trap right in the way there. Squirted some lure in there, and we should have that one soon. Something kind of cool about this setup here is this homeowner, they've only been here a few years, and they didn't realize this, but in the past, these leg hole traps that are hanging on the fence here, I just dug those up out of that woodchuck hole. The previous owner was trying to trap those with the old style leg hole traps. So kind of neat. You don't get to see those every day sitting at a house for woodchucks, but I got them kind of hanging on the fence there as a little piece of history. But we should be back here in a few days to show you what's going on. This is a woodchuck job that we set up almost 2 weeks ago and have not caught anything until today. So we finally got the culprit, but it just took a while to do it. You know, these traps are kind of a positive set, so if they come out of this hole, they have no choice but to go through the cage. So I'm guessing this woodchuck was staying elsewhere as well as using this hole. So just took a while, but the persistence paid off. We eventually got him. So we're gonna go ahead and get him out of here, or her, and get this hole closed back up and keep an eye on it and see what happens. If it gets dug back out, then we'll just set the traps back up. Not a big deal. But at this point, I think we're pretty much done here. I checked the other one in the garden along the fence, and nothing has been touching that one either, so we're going to pull that trap as well. But at least we finally got the one that's been raiding the garden and causing the damage underneath this shed, so I'm happy with the results. You can see the hole that it's been digging underneath that shed there. Here's the woodchuck. Trying to get into its entrance. Thank you very much. This is the part of the day I enjoy the most. At the end of the day, I get to come out to one of my release sites here and release the animals that I caught that day. So right now, I'm just going to show you releasing of this woodchuck. Doesn't get much better than that. That's what it's all about, catching these animals and bringing them out to a new place like this, a new place for them to call home, and you know, they can live happily here. So at Frogger Wildlife, that's what we're about. That's what we, you know, New York's given us the opportunity to do the release program, so that's what I take advantage of whenever possible. Thank you for watching.